Spencer McGowan is from the McGowan Group Asset Management. And the story out is that millennials still lean on their parents for money, but want financial independence. Okay, well, you're still leaning You're still leaning on your parents for money. Spencer McGowan, what's the story here?
Well, you know, I would say that Generation X and especially the baby boomers are probably the most generous generation in history, right? It used to be when you turned 18, your parents would just put all your stuff on the porch and tell you good luck.
Right, right.
And you really do have some shifts in the culture. One of the other things is the student loan crisis. You know, a lot of people bought into the prestigious degree myth, high tuition student loans.
Yep.
And not all of those degrees turned out to be, let's say, sellable in the job market. So that's another factor, especially with the student loan debt being $1.5 trillion.
And you know, if you're as parents, it's built into the law now, where your kid is on your, which I guess is probably a good thing. Your kid is on your health insurance till what, 26 years old?
Yeah, I've got a 24-year-old in Boulder, Colorado.
Yeah,
and so this story is exactly right. I'm in the sandwich generation.
Right.
I send some money to my mom because she's retired and I help her, and then I send money to Boulder because, hey, I only got one son, so it's a lot easier, you know, once you're affluent. I'm the end of the baby boomers, by the way. I'm the youngest of the baby
boomers.
I'm
November 1964, so technically, but I'm not a baby boomer, nor are you. We're not baby boomers, but technically we are. We're in that, we're cut off there, so.
Exactly. We're the cusp. We'll just call it the cusp.
Yeah, we have no group to identify with. It's a sad state of affairs for us. By the way, my son is in Denver. A lot of young people out there love Denver, Boulder. They just love Colorado.
I love it, too. I go about every 3 months, I go up and go hiking during the summer, man.
Yeah.
Any excuse to fly into Denver, get a truck, and go.
Yeah.
So we'll meet you there.
All right, sounds good. That's good. I hike motor vehicle-wise. I'll get in the car and hike in the car. I'm not a big hiker, but my kid is. He's all so. But I find that what they do there is there's so many young people that the pay is not as good as you might think in a city like Denver or Boulder. They're kind of taking.
We're bridging the gap, right?
Yeah, and right. That's
70% of the generation gets parental support. You know, and 50% of the kids in their 30s are getting support, which is like a horrifying figure for me. I don't want to be doing it much longer.
Yeah. So what is the, I mean, is this a parental mistake? Is the system created this mistake? Is it schooling? What has caused this?
Well, if you're a more affluent generation. I mean, back when they put your stuff on the porch at 18 and said good luck, that, you know, that perspective may not have been the best outcome for, you know, specific families and situations.
Right.
So that's one extreme. You know, the other is if the kid's 35, it says 50% of the kids in their 30s are getting some support. So there is a degree of work ethic that hasn't hit a lot of the 73 million millennials in the workforce. I didn't notice that in 2 years, Bureau of Labor Statistics says, hey, in 2 years, 50% of the workforce is going to be millennials. Which I guess is good news for you and I.
Yeah, I guess. I'm hoping.
Well, I don't
know. Will they take care of us? Probably not.
This is the new trend now. Speaking of, you know, you have to assist your children financially and they get to live with you and they're on your insurance. This is why I feel like Walmart and other companies go to this thing where you practically work there. You got to check yourself out. What was the other place I was at recently?
You have to do all the work. Yeah.
I was just somewhere else, too, where it's like a self-checkout, but it's not self-checkout, where basically you take care of yourself. I'm like, what am I doing here?
I do wonder, Spencer, that maybe we're in a situation, though, where we have, and our kids have been brought up this way, and probably this is how we brought ourselves up. Everybody's got a cell phone. Everybody has cable. Mm-hmm. Everybody has, well, you got to go on vacation once or twice a year.
Yeah.
And back when my parents got out of school and at age 18, they got married. My father got a job, two jobs. It was a little different, But we didn't have all of these extra things that we have to pay for today.
No, the cell phone. Yeah, my son's still on the cell phone.
I mean,
the first internet generation, Steve Jobs really fueled the millennial perspective. But, and they're on their phones probably too much. Their social not working when they're supposed to be at work.
Right,
so social not working.
There are some growing up. There's a growing up piece to this for the millennials, and maybe we're guilty of not giving them enough tough love.
Right, by saying, okay, enough is enough.
Yeah, and, Bill, just to follow up on your point, today's day and age, everybody's got a cell phone. Everybody's got an internet bill. Most households have multiple vehicles. When you were growing up, was it like that? Or
no,
the family had a car?
Yeah, we had one
wagon.
Vehicle. We didn't even have cable. So it is a different world. I think the definition of poverty has changed a great deal in this country. It's not the same as it used to be. So, all right, Spencer, any social media you want us to plug for you this morning?
NetWorthRadio.com, my assistant, Alex, he's on the show with me, and we were the first ones to come up with the fact millennials are bigger than the boomers. And so NetWorthRadio.com, we've got the broadcast that's financial, and we try to keep it exciting because finance can be boring.
It can be,
the solution.
Yeah, that's why you throw in the millennial story. It always gets people going. That's a good thing. So, all right, Spencer McGowan, thanks for your time. We appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
All right, have a great day.